kids. And tonight I'm just here with Duke and Tilly. And we've talked about Joseph for many weeks now, probably 2-3 weeks we've talked about Joseph and different parts of his life. And we are not done talking about Joseph either. So tonight I'm going to say a sentence and you're going to tell me if it's true or false. And if it's true, I'm going to give Tilly a pat. And if it's false, I'm going to give Duke a pat. Okay, so here we go. Are you ready? Joseph lived in a family with 12 boys. Is that true or false? It's true, so Tilly gets a pat. He lived in a family of 12 boys. Yes, Tilly loves her pats. Okay, here's number two statement. You tell me if it's true or false. Think about it. Joseph ran away from home when he was 17 years old. Is that true or false? Well, it's false, so Duke gets a pat. It was false. He didn't run away. He was sold by his brothers for 20 shekels. They sold him. Joseph did not run away. Okay, next question, true or false? Joseph's father gave him a coat, but it was just plain blue, and he didn't really like the coat very much, and he didn't have much to wear with it, so Joseph never wore the coat. Is that true or false? Well, it's false, so Duke gets another pat. It was a false statement. The coat was actually so beautiful, and Joseph loved it, and he wore it all the time. It was the coat of many colors. Okay, number four. When Joseph was in jail, he was sad and he never talked to anybody much and he didn't want to do any work. Is that true or false? That is false. So Duke gets another pat. And Duke is actually trying to fall asleep here. He's getting so many pats. In jail, the Bible tells us that Joseph was blessed by God, and even the jailer saw it. The jailer saw that Joseph was a very good worker, and he helped the other prisoners. And so Joseph was actually put in charge at prison too. So here is the last one, true or false. Think about it. God gave Joseph special abilities, and one special ability was to understand what people's dreams meant. True or false? Well, it was true. It's Tilly's turn to get a pat. Yay, Tilly gets another pat. It was true, and Tilly loves to get pat. God gave Joseph many spiritual abilities, and the ability to know the meaning of dreams was just one of them. Joseph was a very good manager, and he was a great organizer too, and he had many special gifts from the Lord. But the most important thing about Joseph was that he loved and he served God. Joseph was God's friend, and that's what we are too. We are friends with God. Thank you, God, for being our friend. Thank you, God, for loving us every day. You are a great God. Hi, kids. I know that by now most of you already know all the words to our Bible verse, but let's say them one more time together tonight. I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. Well, boys and girls, God has plans for Landon and Napoleon and Stephen and Ethan and Wandy. And God has a future for Melissa and Cameron and Liliana. God has a hope for Lane and Joshua and Isla. And tonight, I want to tell you about how God taught this man to be a great leader when he was just a little boy. This man's name is Andrew Kuman, and Andrew comes to our church. And Andrew told me that as a child, he helped in his house in lots of different ways. So Andrew says that he set the table for dinner. He did the dishes and he cleaned up his toys. Way to go, Andrew. And at Christmas, his job was to put out the special Advent candles. And then he told me when he got a bit older, he was able to mow the lawn and he actually helped his brother with his paper route. And then he helped his children's pastor in Sunday school. Way to go, Andrew. Andrew learned how to be a people helper when he was just a little boy. And now Andrew is a famous author and producer, and he's in charge of making movies. But God taught him as a little boy how to be a great leader by helping people. And God can teach that to us too. We can learn how to be great people helpers in our home, even today. Look for a way to be a secret helper. Hi kids. Our story tonight is about another part of Joseph's life. And so in your Action Bible, turn to page 96. Right at the bottom it says, "Even in prison, God is with Joseph. Through these trials, God is forcing Joseph to learn patience and leadership. When the keeper of the jail discovers that Joseph maintains peace in prison, he puts Joseph in charge of all the other prisoners. Well, one day, the king's baker and butler are thrown into prison for making the king mad. Both men have dreams that disturb them, so they come to Joseph. The butler says to him, 'What do my dreams mean?' And Joseph says to the butler, 'In 3 days you will go back to Pharaoh and you will have your high position back. You will be the king's butler again. And please, when you're back with the Pharaoh, please remember me. Please ask Pharaoh to release me. I'm an innocent captive.' Well, Joseph's words come true, and 3 days later, the butler returns to the Pharaoh's castle, but he forgets his promise to Joseph. And one day, the Pharaoh summons the butler again and says, 'I don't want any wine today. I've had a disturbing dream and nobody in my whole kingdom can tell me what it means.' Well, Pharaoh, I know of a Hebrew prisoner and he can tell the meaning of dreams." Pharaoh said, "What are you waiting for? Go get him." Turn over the page to page 98. It says, "The butler wastes no time having Joseph released from prison, and Joseph stands before the Pharaoh of Egypt." The Pharaoh says to Joseph, "Is it true that you can tell the meaning of dreams?" Joseph said, "I can't. I can't. But my God can. Tell me your dream, Pharaoh." And so Joseph was able to tell the Pharaoh what his dream meant. Boys and girls, Joseph loved God very much, and you would call him God's friend. They had a very strong relationship. Joseph loved God, and Joseph was God's friend. And God gave him things. God gave Joseph some very special abilities. Joseph had the ability to organize things and manage things and take care of things. Joseph was very smart. He was a wise man. And so Joseph had another special ability from God, and he could tell people what their dreams meant. These gifts that God gave Joseph, well, they helped people. And they helped people in three different ways. First of all, they helped people know what would happen to them in the future. And second, they helped people to know that God loved them. And third, they helped people to know that God had a plan for them. Just like He has a plan for me and a plan for you. God has plans for us. God has plans for every child to bless you. And the most important plan that God has for every person on earth is that we would actually know Him, that we would be friends with God. God wants every person to be part of His family. And He wants you to know Him by becoming His child, by asking Jesus to be your Savior. Well, I did this a really long time ago, and I know that many of our children have done that too. But maybe there's somebody watching tonight, and you have never asked Jesus to forgive you. You can do it right now. You don't even have to wait. It's a very simple prayer. But the most important prayer that you will ever pray. So let's do it. Bow your heads and close your eyes and say these words after me. Dear God, thank you for Jesus. Thank you that He died for me. Please forgive me of all the wrong things that I have done. I'm sorry. Please come into my heart and into my life, I give them to you. And please help me to live for you every day. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, thank you, God, for being our friend. And if you prayed that prayer for the very first time, congratulations! God is with you, and He has great plans for your life. You can celebrate being a child of God, and you can celebrate being a friend of God. You are now God's friend. And as we close today, let's sing that song, I Am a Friend of God, because that is what we are.